What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. Before we get started today, I wanted to show you guys, I got my first My Corvette Life t-shirt in the mail. I think it looks pretty good. If you are curious about some My Corvette Life t-shirts, there's a link in the description below, and I also just released a new design. I like it very much, and it's been up just about 24 hours, and I've already sold a few of them, so definitely go check it out. Link in the description below. Let me know what you think. Today's topic is going to be the manual transmission. If you saw my previous video, there was some leaked images of the new C8 interior, and I posted my thoughts on that. If you haven't seen that video, I'll put the little card at the top of the screen. Definitely go check that out. But in that video, I had mentioned that the manual transmission may be dead. And today, an article in Road and Track came out that may have solidified that. So today was the first day of the Detroit Auto Show, and the big, you know, reveal at this year's Detroit Auto Show was the new Ford Mustang GT500. So if you noticed in that video, it said that that car has a new dual clutch transmission. Now, I'm gonna link down below the article to the Road and Track article I had mentioned. Basically, that transmission, which is also made by Tremec, it is the TR9007, is a 7-speed dual clutch automatic transmission. That transmission was originally designed for General Motors. And if you guys may or may not know, the 10-speed automatic that is currently in the Mustang as well as the Camaro, that's also made by Tremec, and that was made for GM and Ford to use in their cars. The 10-speed automatic does not fit in the current C7 Corvette. That's why the Corvette currently uses the 8-speed automatic. So there's a little bit of knowledge for you guys. But that brings me to say this new dual clutch transmission, it looks like it's headed for the C8 Corvette and will be used in this GT500 and possibly in future Mustang models as well. So that is the future of the Corvette. We kind of had an idea that this new car was going to have a dual clutch. That just seems to be the, you know, linear progress that the car should make. And as I said before, just by the layout of the center console, it looks like that it will not have a manual transmission option. Now, this new automatic, from what the website over on Tremec's website, says that this is good for a little over 600 foot-pounds of torque, which is a lot, but as we know in the current ZR1, we're making over that. So possibly down the road in some of the higher up models of the Corvette, who knows what we might see. We do know most turbocharged cars don't make as much torque as the naturally aspirated or even the supercharged Corvettes that we've come to know have been making. But we'll see what happens. But it's looking like the manual transmission is dead. Just for some statistics, I looked up what the 2017 Corvette production numbers were. There were 32,782 total Corvettes built for the 2017 model year. And out of that, only 7,226 of all Corvettes were manual. That's just about 22%. And although there are no actual statistics, I think the vast majority of automatic transmission owners are of the older generation. Because personally, the Corvette owners that are around my age demographic that I hang out with around Phoenix, I would say over 90% of them have manual transmissions. Sides to the story. I think there's the people that just don't like being bothered shifting their own gears anymore, and then I think there's the people that are just obsessed with having the absolute fastest thing out there. Personally, I know the automatics are much faster nowadays than anybody can shift manually, but it also takes the driver involvement and personal satisfaction of rowing your own gears out of the whole experience of the ownership of the vehicle. I would say less than 1% of Corvette owners actually track their vehicle, and I would say even less than that actually track their vehicle for lap times. Most people that go to track days just go there to have a good time, not to set a fastest lap. And that is going to do it for today's video. Just a little FYI, this week is Barrett Jackson in Scottsdale. I will be there Wednesday night and all day Saturday. So I will be getting some coverage for you guys, so stay tuned for that. And if you haven't seen the new t-shirts and hoodies, link is in the description below. Please go check it out. I hope you guys like it. Show me some support. Purchase a t-shirt. Let me know what you think. And that's going to do it for today's video. If you like today's video, please smash the thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. And until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.